Hallo.
Although they were still mourning the loss of their grandma, they had to continue their mission. Two more spirits of Rhea needed to be freed and brought to the safety of their home. John thought they should be able to find the temple that housed Anairaha, the spirit of the winds, somewhere in the city of Berahat. Maybe he could shed some more light on the nature of the corruption and the mountain god. A colossal monument built to the ruler of Berahat and the voice of Anairaha, Bushra herself. A twisted prison of hate and decadence.
Decadence? Kevin Chang. Ziggurat.
Long one.
Two people, one old and one young, surely did not belong in a clearing of windswept sand. The older was nervous, looked at his surroundings as if for the first time. But an air of wisdom still lingered around him. They were on the run, and in search of one more able-bodied than themselves, for a monstrous and savage creature had begun to dwell near the observatory. "The skies," he said. "The skies hold the secrets of the gods." Steam. It was perhaps more powerful than a horse. Is nowhere near as reliable.
Range ke? Oh! Sushi.
The flying creature they were seeing in the sky filled Lucy with excitement. Could it be a dragon? However, Kevin had heard Mark say that there were no dragons left on Rhea, and he told Lucy the same.
Oh no, dragon died.
It wasn't hard for Uncle Ben to guess that this strange woman was from the far north. The Bergsons were curious to know her reason for making such a long and arduous trip down south.
The dragon is dead.
The details Apon knew about fighting the corruption surprised the family and stirred more than a little respect for her. Yet more surprising was the fact that the wife of a tribe chief would take unto herself to journey south and give aid to the Bergsons.
Wife. Husband.
Apon joining in with the Bergsons would help them in their quest. Moreover, Mark could learn a thing or two from her in the art of combat.
What a weird character. I thought you were family. You are not family. Sorry, Mark. Later, Mark. My Apang. Mid-range warrior she can take. Magic glyph. Primary attack feels her. Feel her energy. I don't know. Come on!
Come on!
Breaking the circle would prevent the summoning. Had they only been quicker.
Kala. Kala pa. Kala pa ba?
Mary had already started studying Margaret's books of potion making and recipes before the disaster had struck. She worked through them cautiously and patiently. After all, someone had to follow in Grandma's footsteps and help the family in their efforts.
Sister is dead. Marky boy, let's go. That's Kevin. Thanks, boy. Come.
Only the worthy may pass through such a barrier.
Rich opinion.
Relic of yesterday's ambitions, still potent.
Oh, sorry. Let's go. Jigula.
Something more sinister would be appearing soon. A new challenger appeared. When tormenting their own citizens was not enough. The corrupted turned to crueler entertainment. Strained music played from another unwilling entertainer, but the melody failed to hide the sound of her sizzling flesh. Having been chained and tortured, it was no surprise the poor creature would immediately flee from her liberators. Adam continues about their run-ins with the bandits. Momentary reprieve and a prize to pick up. Push. Magic and lost powers hung heavy in the chamber.
Wow. Very nice. Dang.
He instead adopted the title Mysterious Shopkeep.
Just a throw it right now, thank you.
Two people, one old and one young, surely did not belong in the clearing of windswept sand. The older was nervous, looked at his surroundings as if for the first time. But an air of wisdom still lingered around him. The skies, he said. The skies hold the secrets of the gods. Steam. It was perhaps more powerful than a horse, but it was nowhere near as reliable. The creature that now threatened the hero was a crudely focused inferno of hatred and malice. With the observatory now safe from the belligerent beast, the two were once again free to observe the heavens.
But alas, I need to run. So, how to? Can I just kill myself? Maybe I can kill myself or eat the boss.
The sun baked the captive, nearly worked to death with such little water.
Can you...
A shaper of stone without equal. He thanked the Bergson and asked to be visited if any ruins were in need of mending. Wish that their mother was alive was a shared longing for Ben and John. The younger son placed Margaret's staff on the same pedestal he had taken his father's sword from, his mind wondering about the truth of the horrific secret that their mother had left for them in her final letter. The fruit lay before them, gathered out of gratitude. There was nothing but a few footprints to betray who may have left it there.
Bear. The bear.
It was merely a soothing potion Mark sought among his grandma's books. But what he found was like a bolt of lightning through his heart. They would have to sacrifice the newborn babe to the mountain god to stem the tide of the corruption and save the world. Knowledge sometimes brings great suffering to the compassionate.
Okay, bye-bye, Johnny.